Hello aviators, how are you? My name is Magnan Rudal. I'm an ATR captain and instructor. Today is Saturday, 10th of August, 2024. Yesterday, an ATR 72-500 from Voipas Lineas Aéreas performing flight 2283 from Cascavel to Viracopos in Brazil spent auto control and crashed about 7 nautical miles off east of the airport. According to Aviation Herald, all 61 passengers and crew perished. My condolences goes to the family of the perished. And this is what we know so far. Videos recorded from the ground shows the aircraft descending in a flat spin. This is very unusual. For an aircraft to spin, it must stall first. And when this stall occurs, there must be a yawing force, like application of a rudder. This will cause one wing to stall before the other. And as that wing drops, the angle of attack increases further, increasing the stall of that wing. And the aircraft will start to rotate, and that is the spin. In a normal spin, the nose of the aircraft is pointing steeply towards the ground. And the recovery depends on the aircraft type. In a light aircraft, the standard recovery procedure is called pare. Power to idle, ailerons to neutral, rudder opposite of the spin, and elevators forward, down. Some aircraft will recover when you reduce the power to idle and let go the controls. Others require a very specific procedure. Multi-engine aircraft, the engine attached to the wings, are much harder to recover, if it's possible at all. The reason is the engines are far away from the center of gravity of the aircraft. Engines are heavy, so they create a strong gyroscopic force. A spin can then develop into a flat spin, which means the nose position is much higher than in a normal spin. A flat spin can happen if the power is not reduced. The ailerons are applied in the opposite direction of the spin, and or the center of gravity is too far aft. So there are many conditions that can lead to a flat spin. And when you are in a flat spin, the normal spin recovery technique will not work because the tail fin and the rudder is stalled. So it has no effect. All transport category aircraft, Boeing, Airbus, ATR, are not certified or tested for spin. Instead, they have equipment that will prevent you from stalling the aircraft. ATR aircraft is equipped with a stall warning system that will warn the flight crew before the stall occurs. When the angle of attack increases beyond a certain value, the stick shaker and an oral will be activated. And this video shows how it's tested. We do this test before first flight of the day. And after 10 seconds in the test, the stick pusher is activated. It's very strong. I could not even hold it. So that prevents you from entering a stall. According to Flight Radar 24, a signal for severe icing between flight level 120 and flight level 210 was valid from 1530 to 1930 Zulu, that is UTC time. The accident aircraft was flying at flight level 170. What is severe icing? It is defined as a condition where the rate of ice accretion is such that anti-icing and de-icing may fail to reduce or control the hazard. ATR aircraft have a reputation of being unsafe in icing. This happened because of American Eagle Flight 4184 in 1994. There have been three other accidents related to severe icing. The last two ones happened because the flight crew were waiting for ATC clearance to descend. And while they were waiting, they lost airspeed, the aircraft stalled, and they lost control. After the accident with American Eagle 4184, ATR has improved the ice protection systems and demonstrated that the aircraft can fly in severe icing with water drops bigger than certification standard was at that time. Until 2015, no new aircraft types were certified for flight in severe icing. Today, new aircraft must prove that they can fly in severe icing for a period at least long enough to be able to escape severe icing. A danger with severe icing is that the stall warning system may not be triggered before the wing is so contaminated with ice that it will stall earlier. Therefore, ATR is equipped with a performance monitoring system, and it will alert the crew if there is excessive drag, reducing the performance of the aircraft because of a lot of ice building up on the airframe, because this creates extra drag. When you have indication of severe icing, the procedure is to increase your speed to 30 knots above minimum speed for icing conditions with flap zero. That speed is marked with a red bug on the airspeed indicator. And then you have to add 30 knots to that. And this may result in a forced descent. But this is an emergency, so you don't have to wait for the clearance for ATC to descend. You just make sure you have the speed, then you can send a medic call to ATC. Because when it comes to ice, speed is life. And when it comes to dispatching aircraft into known or forecast severe icing, I expect that every company have written in their operations manual that this is not allowed. They should have that paragraph in their rules. ADBS data published by Aviation Herald shows a strange flight path. At 16:21 and 2 seconds, the aircraft is at flight level 170. At 16:21 11 seconds, it has descended to flight level 167. At 16:21 22 seconds, it has climbed to flight level 172. That is 500 feet in 11 seconds, and that gives an average rate of climb of 2,700 feet per minute. The ATR cannot climb steadily with that rate, so that means it lost speed. At the same time, there was a sharp turn to the right, and at 16:21, 29 seconds, the aircraft had descended to flight level 155 in 7 seconds, and that is 1,700 feet, giving an average rate of 14,500 feet per minute. At 16:21:33, the aircraft is here at flight level 148, and 2 seconds later, it is here at what appears to be flight level 142. Then it's suddenly back to the previous position, and now at flight level 121. It means in 12 seconds, it lost 2,700 feet with an average rate of 13,500 feet per minute. At 16:21:50 seconds, the aircraft was at flight level 111, which means it has lost another 1,000 feet in 5 seconds. That is 12,000 feet per minute. The aircraft continued descending with this rate until the last data point. Okay, that is all we know so far. There are many questions. We cannot speculate what happened. There's so many possibilities. So we have to wait, be patient, and wait for investigators to do the job and draw the conclusions. Thank you for watching.